Okay, in the news which has just come in, two more people, Abu Bakr and Abdul Hamid, have been arrested by the Customs Department in the gold smuggling case. Both of them hail from Mallapuram district. Neetu Regukumar is with us from Thiruvananthapuram. Neetu, the net certainly seems to be widening the significance of these two arrests.
Definitely more and more arrests are being made by the customs. Yesterday also two more arrests have been made, and they are concentrating on this entire network, not just from where it starts but where this gold is finally reaching, to whose hands it's reaching and who has raised their money. Even as we talk, there are raids, customs raids happening at a jewelry in Kozhikode also. So that is the entire net that the customs is trying to look into, this entire group, where the gold is finally reaching after coming in through these routes from the airport, Pallavi.
And do you think it is also snowballing into a political, a political issue, like Congress Party, for example, gunning for the Kerala Chief Minister and so on and so forth?
It's definitely a political controversy, and they have actually put the Chief Minister in the defensive, because it was the Chief Minister's principal secretary to Chief Minister who had alleged links to this, one of the suspects, and he was questioned for almost 9 hours. He was suspended yesterday, but still opposition leader Ramesh Chennitala going on to say that they won't stop with just the suspension of Mr. Shiv Shankar. The Chief Minister has to answer on this. They want the Chief Minister's office to be questioned, and they say that these links, because the Chief Minister was shielding Shiv Shankar till now, so they're not going to end it with that. Now the Congress is given a notice for a no confidence motion, so they'll be moving against the state government as well as the Speaker also. So this is something which they will keep the momentum on, Pallavi, and we know that the elections is a year down. Yes. In 2021 is when Kerala should go to elections, and the local body elections are another 6 months. So that is something, this will keep the heat, the political heat will be high in this case.
And Neetu, about the gunman who has now been found, is it intriguing? Where was he found? What are the details?
Now, the gunman went missing yesterday afternoon. According to his family, the family gave the complaint last night itself to the Tumpa police station, because for the past 2 days, 3 days, he was really upset. He was saying that he will be targeted or he will be pinned in this. So he was very upset about it. He was worried. And according to the family members, he was also scared about whether he will be brought into all. So he was not saying more about it, but he was genuine, very worried is what we are getting to know. So yesterday, once he went missing, immediately the family approached the police. This gunman is a civil police officer with the Kerala police. He was sent on duty to attach to the council general. So once they went to the police started, they registered a case, and they have started looking. Today, when the police party was in the ancestral home in that area of this person, nearby in a discarded area, full of grass. So in that area, the neighbors found him lying down, and he was sobbing, and he also had a wound on his on his wrist. So the police immediately rushed him to the hospital. So while he was being taken into the jeep, he was heard crying and saying that he is not involved in any scam. He's not involved in the gold smuggling case. And they immediately rushed him to the hospital.
Okay. Thank you very much, Neetu, for getting us those details. And as you pointed out, it certainly has become now a political issue in Kerala as well. In fact, let's listen to some of those voices. V. Muralidharan as well as Ramesh Chennitala, both of them spoke to CNN News 18.
Merely by suspending the principal secretary will not help. The chief minister's office is totally involved in this scam, and it should be, chief minister should be interrogated, and also the fact should be unearthed by the national agency like CBI. So that is why we are asking for a CBI inquiry, separate inquiry in this case. The day one onwards, we are demanding for his resignation.
this attaché at the UAE consulate here in Thiruvananthapuram, the consul general in charge, has left the country, is what we are understanding. We understand that the customs had actually put in a request with you all to interview the person. Where does it stand, sir?
UAE embassy has told us, not formally but informally, that they will consult their Ministry of Foreign Affairs and then get back to us. Oh. Formally, they have not replied. We have sent the that's why we send a reminder. Issue is beyond the normal gold smuggling issues, which are handled by the customs. The government is very serious that such cases should be taken to its logical conclusion, and everybody who are connected with such crimes, mm-hmm, should be brought before law.
Okay.
Now, the attaché's presence in the country or outside, we are not aware formally about whether he has left or not. Since customs had already asked us to have an interview, mm-hmm, and if the investigating agencies feel that they need the inputs from the diplomat, then we will take it up at the diplomatic level.